Jim, don't do it. Don't do it. If you value our partnership, don't do it. We've been putting it in together for 9 years. Don't do it, Jim.
Do it.
Jim, don't do it, Jim.
Do it.
So Google has finally decided to ditch Samsung, and that's actually great news for all of us. You see, the Google-Samsung relationship has improved a great deal in recent years. With both appearing at each other's keynotes, there have been joint ad campaigns and more. Samsung and Google have been giving preferential treatment to each other, and there's a clear strategic reason for doing this, and it's simply because both of them have a lot to gain from each other. But it looks like things are changing, because Google has decided to ditch Samsung, which in turn will improve the Pixel phones quite dramatically. See, Google teamed up with Samsung for the Tensor chipset. These processors are semi-custom designs, effectively being Samsung Exynos processor with some Google components such as their machine learning chip on top. The result we got was a chip that is excellent in machine learning and AI-related tasks such as magic eraser, photo unblur, real tone, and even real-time voice dictation. These are a marked improvement over previous attempts both by Google and other players in the smartphone industry. But where the chip lagged behind is in raw performance, battery life, and thermal throttling. The performance of the latest Pixel flagship is almost a couple of years behind from the competition. And the blame here doesn't go to Google, but instead to Samsung Foundry, because their Exynos chips as well as their chip manufacturing process aren't just good enough. That's the reason Samsung's own mobile division ditched their Exynos chips as well as their own manufacturing in favor of Snapdragon chips and TSMC fabrication, and that has worked wonders for the company. Not only the S23 Ultra is way more powerful than its predecessor, but it's also way more efficient. So the problem here is Exynos and Samsung's chip manufacturing, and it looks like Google has finally realized that and has decided to ditch not only their Exynos chips, but their Foundry altogether. Yes, that means Google is all set to launch their first fully custom Tensor chipset for the Pixel phones. According to a report from The Information, Google will launch the Tensor G5 chip in 2025 as its first fully custom chip. That means the Pixel 10 lineup will have this new chipset. The report mentions that Google originally intended to develop its own in-house design for the Tensor G4 chip next year itself. However, the plans have been abandoned due to difficulties in coordination between Google's American and Indian teams, as well as significant staff turnover. So the project was delayed to 2025. But still, this is great news because, as you're aware, that one of the reasons the iPhone works so well is due to the synergy of its hardware and software. Since Apple Silicon is fully customized, the company has endless control over it and can optimize it to best work with iOS. So Google can also do the same now, as this shift will mean they will have all the controls over their software and hardware. Plus, the shift to TSMC fabrication would mean gone are the days when Pixel phones lacked in performance, battery life, and thermal throttling. These all problems will be solved just by shifting to TSMC production, as Samsung itself proved with the S23 Ultra. And even for non-Pixel users, this is great news simply because competition drives innovation, and in the end, the consumer always wins. Let me know your thoughts, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.